Hello everyone and welcome back to Animaze by Facerig. Animaze by Facerig has put a new feature in now. It's called Personas, which allows you to build a persona of yourself in a character. So if you're not comfortable having your face on screen, then you can create this persona and have this do all the visual facial work for you. Let's find out how. Hello everyone, it's been a while since I've covered an update on Animaze, and there's plenty of updates to talk about today. For those of you not familiar with Animaze, there's a link in the video up in the top right hand corner of the screen that will show you how to use Animaze end to end. We're here, I've made my persona, and here it is on the screen. Lots of other backgrounds as well that have also been put in, a couple of new releases. Some nice backgrounds as well you can put in as well. I put you in a podcast booth, for example. All that sort of stuff. You've got a little microphone. Let's move that out the way. So, you know, if you're not comfortable about having your face on screen, and a lot of people aren't, then perhaps this could be the tool for you. Animaze by Facerig and the Personas option. So let's start right back at the beginning on how to make a persona. Now we're all familiar with the shark, or we should be, and all the other comedy avatars you can have within Facerig. So we should all know this. But this new feature, Persona, takes it away from the inbuilt avatars that we have on the screen, such as the bear, Father Christmas, you know, the fox, the burger, one of my personal favourites, and allows you to turn around and put yourself or a persona of yourself on the screen. This is all done by clicking on the avatars button we've got here and then going to personas. Then you are asked to select whether you want to be a man or a lady, male or female. So we'll go for, say, a female one and say confirm. That loads a base female template onto the screen. And once you've got that base template, then you can start to manipulate it. Now, by default, they've given me red hair, green eyes, and whatnot. So what we're going to do now is we are going to just move ourselves up so we can see. Now, you can zoom in and out as well. So you can see my avatar is pretty much flat shoes, jeans, white t-shirt, and away you go. Right, okay. So we rotate round. Standard avatar picture. Okay, so, well, a bit of screen tearing, I have to say. A bit surprised by that. So then you say, customize the body. So we're gonna customize our body. So skin color, well, you know, we're about there, I think, probably in the skin tone color. Then your face shape, pick your face shape of your avatar. So we'll go for, perhaps say a little fuller face. Scrolling down, eyebrows. Now you can start to get really creative with some multicolored stuff. So you can either have some red eyebrows as well, should you want to. We can have a nice monobrow. All depends, whatever floats your boat, or something nice and bushy. And then you can say the color of your eyes. So, I mean, we've got lovely green eyes here. We can go for blue. Look at that. It's a bit spooky, isn't it? Even violet ones. And then your eye shape. So we can change that as well for different eye shapes. Moving down is the ears. Well, we can't really see the ears as well, but you are given the option to put them, make them bigger or smaller, or you can have Vulcan ears. Now, if we just move now to the side, you can see that's put the Vulcan ears on, and you can have them bigger or smaller. All depends, you want to be a bit of an elf. Really? Or you want to go down the whole Star Trek route? Clicking off the ears button removes them to normal. Okay, so again, holding the control key down, moving the mouse allows us to put our avatar there. Okay, moving on. Now it's time for the nose. You can go for a big old trumpet of a snooter, you know, something a bit more pointed, or down for something which they call their default nose, or more petite. Perhaps you've had a bit of surgery. Who knows? Boom, who knows? Get that? Anyway, there you are. So we've gone for that nose. Scrolling down now, the mouth, what curve do you want? You want to put a bit of lippy on there as well? Who knows? And the shape, where you have for a nice Cupid's bow or for something a bit more wider. Facial hair. Now, typically, you know, for a female avatar, you're not going to have facial hair. You might, though. You might have a little bit of stubble. Who knows? You can create it or not create as much as you want. To remove this, click on it again. Again, you can have different facial hair should you want it, and then remove it. And that's all the options we've got there in regards to the head. Then you're given the option to change your hairstyle. So the hairstyle now, I can go for the sort of dumb and dumber look, a bit like a tea cozy, not a fan of that. You can have short hair, looks quite nice. Medium hair, you get the idea anyway. You can really create something a bit funky should you want to. So there's my female avatar. Scrolling down, there's all long hair as well. There's a bit of a mullet going on there, I suppose. Or you can go for the whole sort of like bunches sort of theme. Right, so there we go. Now hair, all good stuff. You can change your hair color. Have a bit of pink if you want it. A bit of purple as well. Also a bit of brown, more conventional. Or you can go for complete white. So let's try that. That's quite good, isn't it? Next up is clothes. Now, there's a limited amount of clothes. Obviously, you'll be able to buy more in the store when it becomes available. Holding the control key down and scrolling out with the mouse, we can get a full look at our avatar. So the moment they're wearing jeans, quite easily put them in a skirt. All right. Shoes, well, shoes are default shoes. You can always get more from the prop store. And you can change the top as well. So there you are. They are very respectable. I'm staying away from the green of the jumper, right? We've got here the hoodie, simply because if you want to use a green screen with this, then it's more than likely going to clash. But they've really gone to great lengths on the textures of the jumper. Let's just scroll up a bit. Excellent texturing there as well. So we're going to go with a blouse and a pair of jeans. And there's our avatar. Next up is textures as well. It gives you a warning, color customizations and imported textures can interact differently with anticipated colors. And it's up to you if you want to upload different textures as well. Also, you can put in props such as glasses. There you are. They're a bit big, but you can size those as well, you know, to your avatar. Should you be ocularly challenged and need to have glasses or just want to use them as a prop, or you can have something a bit more, you know, multicolored. And for that, you know, anything funky, they're going to charge you a credit score as well. So we'll go with some glasses like that. So, and we can expand them. And there's our avatar. And that's what it's all about. And we can save that avatar. And then you'll notice it'll come down to the bottom of the screen where our avatars are stored. There you go. I can also quite easily change to my male avatar. Confirm. Once you've saved it, that'll then populate and change the avatar to female to male, providing you've made a male avatar. I mean, the options are exactly the same on how to make that. And there's my male avatar looking all surly. Now you may decide you want to go back in there and customize that again. If your personas are getting a bit out of hand, you can select one and remove it without confirming it. Brings up the little trash icon, click on delete, say remove, and that's that one particular avatar gone. And then you can also go back, look at all avatars in the store. There may be some new ones you haven't seen, some you want to buy with your credits, and away you go. Few anime ones there as well. So that was avatars, everybody. Hope you've enjoyed. You find it easy. Hope you're enjoying Animaze by Facerig as well. It is quite easy as well to put this into the props as well, and we'll discuss that in another video. But for now, thanks very much for watching. Like and subscribe if you haven't already done so, and check out Animaze by Facerig on Steam. It really is a good bit of fun. See you soon.